Welcome back, students. So now we're going to solve for another radical equation. Here we have square root of x plus square root of x minus 9 equals 1. And remember, before I solve the problem, I always write down this equation, which is a plus 2 times a times b plus b squared. So I always write it down so that way I could just easily plug in when I'm solving the equation. So here you go. Remember, I always look at the square root of x and also the square root of x minus 9 and see which one is the smaller number. Usually the smaller number I bring to the right. So we're going to subtract square root of x. And remember, what you do to one side, you do to the other. So you're left with square root of x minus 9 equals 1 minus square root of x. You square it, you square it. So here you're left with x minus 9 equals 1 minus square root of x squared. Now you're going to be left over with solving for this part. So the a is going to be the 1, and then your b is going to be just square root of x. It's not going to be negative because we usually don't transfer the negative, so it just stays the same. You're going to be here with a, which is going to be 1, and square root of x, which is going to be your b. So 1 plus 2 times a, which is 1, times b, which is square root of x, plus b squared, which is square root of x squared, and you're going to solve. So you're going to be here with 1 plus 2 times 1 is 2, square root of x, just bring it here. This cancels out. A square root and a square cancel out, so you're just left with x. So you're going to put plus x. Now, remember, we're still solving, so you have to kind of bring this part of the equation in. So I always usually link them together here. So x minus 9 here you have on this side. You're going to have 1 plus 2 square root of x plus x. And you're going to be left over with subtracting x on one side. What you do to one side, you do to the other. You're going to be left with negative 9 equals 1 plus 2 square root of x. Subtract by 1, subtract by 1, you're going to be left with negative 10 equals 2 square root of x, divide by 2, divide by 2. You are going to be left with negative 5 here, and then it's going to be square root of x. Now remember, you're going to have to square it to cancel it out, and what you do to one side, you do to the other, so you're going to be left with, and the negative is going to cancel out too, because remember, you're multiplying negative 5 times negative 5, which is 25. So you're just gonna have 25 equals x. Now you think you have your answer, but you do not. Because remember, once you solve, you always have to check for your answer. So now we're gonna have to check. And how we check is by plugging in the original equation. So here we go. We're gonna have, I'll put check here. We're gonna have square root of x plus square root of x minus 9 equals 1, which is our original equation. So now we have to plug in 25 for x. So here we're gonna have square root of 25 plus square root of 25 minus 9 equals 1. So to solve now, square root of 25 is 5. You're gonna be 25 minus 9 is 16. So you're gonna have 16 equals 1. The square root of 16 is 4. So you have 4 and then bring down the 5. 5 plus 4 equals 1. Then 5 plus 4 equals 9. And 9 is not 1. So this is not equal. So the answer to this equation is no solution. That's why it's always important to check your answer. And that's your answer.